we are going to be putting the new web, Dayton Web Developers website into GitHub Pages.
Sounds great.
So a lot of these images of the pull requests people from the group that want to contribute, just do a pull request and add whatever to the site.
Yeah, when I eventually redesign my personal site, I'm strongly looking into putting it up on GitHub Pages as well.
Also, another thing about GitHub, again, by default, it is assuming that this is Jekyll contents. So if you wanted to go with my experience with the gold starter from Sparkbox, is that it's using the underscore file format, which Jekyll ignores underscore files.
Okay.
So you have to put in a dot ignore Jekyll, or no Jekyll, dot no Jekyll, which will turn off the Jekyll rules.
Okay.
Any restrictions on content that may be placed on GitHub Pages?
You mean like,
just, you know, any restrictions?
Anything.
Like,
it's another repo.
Images with bad language or obscene photos or something like that.
I'm sure they've got terms and conditions, but I have never really seen
them.
I mean, you want to be comfortable, definitely shouldn't put anything private up there because if it's on GitHub Pages, it's public. The repos are public, and it's publicly accessible via the internet. Yeah.
Are you able to do it with a private repo?
You can do it with a private repo. So
that's not free, right?
Right.
Private repos are not free. You can do GitHub Pages with a private repo, but again, once you put them up there, then the site itself will be public. Even if your repo is not public, you can still access the site on the internet.